Our lives are so fundamentally shifted by energy, and it has for a long time felt that that was a very good thing. We are still seeing a growth in energy demand, but that is beginning to shift more towards electrical.
With this energy transition taking place, lithium-ion batteries play a huge part in the energy transition in our society. The demand comes from more and more electrical vehicles and phasing out fossil fuels with renewable energy production. Our mission is to produce the world's greenest battery. The demand for lithium-ion batteries is increasing. It's skyrocketing. In the battery cell, we need to use metals such as nickel, manganese, cobalt. A part of our battery cell's CO2 footprint today comes from mining. So it's hard to find the metals. They're finite, they're expensive. That is why it's so important that we succeed in recycling old batteries. Northvolt was started in Sweden. We are the first battery producer in Europe. We are running our production on renewable energy, sourcing metals sustainably, and our goal is to have 50% of what we put into a new battery cell come from recycling in 2030. When our first gigafactory is built, we will produce battery cells for 1 million electrical vehicles every year in the north of Sweden.
Traditionally, we have seen low volumes of lithium-ion batteries coming back to recycling, probably because the technology had not yet been developed to recycle these materials back into the high purity levels that is needed. Northvolt was able to develop the process that could take these spent battery materials, process them through to a battery-grade recycled metal, then circled back into the battery cell production.
So when we get our end-of-life battery packs, we discharge them first, which is the first step in the recycling process. After that, it goes into a dismantling where we pick apart the battery pack. And in the cell, we have all the critical materials that we want to use in our battery production. And then the cells we send into crushing and sorting. What we want is what we call black mass, which contains the lithium, the nickel, the manganese, and the cobalt. This we then send into the hydrometallurgical process, which is a chemical treatment where we separate out the different minerals.
We can recover very high levels of the metals. We're not losing a lot, which many other similar processes cannot. We can do it over and over again. So all of this combined means lower energy consumption, and we're slicing the CO2 footprint compared to virgin or freshly mined material.
Having battery production and our supply chain for the European automotive industry here in Europe reduces the climate footprint. We can do things more sustainable, and we can do it faster, and we can do it safer.
We haven't really thought about re-engineering the process completely. I think what we're beginning to see now is people coming at these problems from completely different angles. Like completely redefining chemical process.
Here at Northvolt Labs, we look at developing new materials, and if we can reduce the amount of metals, we can also reduce the CO2 footprint from our battery cell. Alongside lithium-ion batteries, we have now developed a sodium-ion battery.
So sodium differs from the traditional lithium-ion product from the material perspective. The source already exists in the environment where we are living. Salt is available around us. It doesn't use any rare minerals or toxic minerals like nickel and cobalt.
And what is so interesting about the sodium ion battery is that it's cheaper, it's more sustainable, and it can take heat much better than the lithium ion battery can.
We have been able to crack the code to improve the safety and also the high temperature performance, which makes it very attractive in the southern region.
Right now, we are producing test cells that we can share with our potential customers. And what we see for sodium ion is that it will be used primarily for energy storage in connection with renewable energy production.
I think you can see where companies are coming in with innovative ideas, that they'll begin to say, no, we can do this, and we can do it cheaper, and we can do it better. And it will allow us to do technologies like renewables and start to make a real shift on the energy transition.
What we can do differently now is that we can actually address the matter of recycling. We can close the loop and produce battery cells at scale.
So there's not like one solution to the climate crisis, but batteries will play a key part in this transition.
And that's really where we are now, is that we've gone through this societal shift where our society is based on energy, and we now need to figure out how we decarbonize that if we want to continue on that pathway.